Well, hello Libra, welcome to my channel. This is Victoria at Radiant Moon Tarot, and we're here doing your weekly reading for July 5th through 11th, 2021. If you're new to my channel, welcome in, and if you're returning, welcome back, and I'm truly grateful for all of your likes, shares, subscribes, and your fabulous energy. So just a reminder to everybody, this is a general reading, so not all the messages will resonate with everybody. Just take the parts that apply to your situation, leave the rest behind. You may also want to check out your Moon, Rising, and Venus sign readings as well for some more information. So let's see what we've got for you guys. So this week we have July 9th or 10th, depending on where you are in the world. We've got a new moon in Cancer. So with this being in the sign of Cancer, this may be a time to contemplate the relationships in your life, business relationships, friendships, familyships, and yes, also romantic relationships, improvements, new ones, and in some cases, letting some go. All right, but this is also a very exciting week ahead, an exciting new moon, and this is all about positive change, freedom from attachment or anything that's holding you back. And it's just, you know, it may have a couple of ups and downs, but ultimately it is very exciting energy. So first out, we have diversity, the Five of Scrolls, and we also have the Eight of Roses, and this is Sangha, this is community. So this is really, you know, interesting energy. The Five of Scrolls, this is a little bit about putting all your eggs in one basket. Is there a place in your life where you are out of balance? You are putting all of your time, attention, and dedication into one thing, and you know, there may be other opportunities that are around you, okay, or you need to kind of reassess your situation and find a little bit of balance. You may be bordering, it may be bordering on obsession. Diversity can also be about looking at things from a different perspective. You know, for example, if you're looking for a new job, perhaps you're really pigeonholing yourself into one particular area, and there may be other opportunities that are really plentiful that are around you, but it may require you to kind of, you know, have a look. Have not necessarily elsewhere, but kind of broaden your horizons. But ultimately, this is a time of expansion for you to try new things, you know, to expand your horizons and to really kind of put yourself out there in situations. So when we do have this time of expansion, this growth, okay, this really is a really good time to do all of that and to really kind of try different things, go different places, meet new people, and don't really worry about spreading yourself too thin in a situation. Of course, always take care of yourself, but when we do have a period of expansion, this really does give you the energy boost that you need to, you know, to diversify your energy a little bit. But we have the Eight of Roses here as well, and this is all about community. So this is a wonderful time for you to have a look at your relationships, as we already said. And there are a lot of people that are around you that you can surround yourself with and that have your best interest at heart. They share your common interest. And if you don't feel as though there's people around you like that, it doesn't mean throw the people you have away. It means go meet new ones. And especially if you've got some special interests or anything, some hobbies, or even something to do with your career, where you just sometimes may want to talk to and bounce ideas off of some other people who kind of are in the same boat. There's that that opportunity for you there to do a little bit of networking in your situation. So whether it's networking, if you're single, trying to find new love, okay, whether it's, you know, finding a group of like-minded people that share the same hobbies, the same interests, okay, or that workplace, all right. But this can also be about your family, your friends, and spending a little bit of time with them. They're supportive. If you need some help, some assistance, all right, don't be afraid to ask. Okay, so it's a wonderful energy there when we get that community energy. So let's see what else we've got for you guys this week. Messages, please, for Libra for the week ahead. Thank you. So first out, we've got the King of Swords. We've got the Sun. I love the Sun. And we've got the Five of Wands. And I get another one with that. And we've got the World. All right. Advice from Spirit. We've got the King of Pentacles. And your outcome energy. We have the Four of Cups. And I'll get a second one with that too. And a Page of Cups. Okay. So this is really quite nice. I mean, you know, with the King of Cups, you really do have the ability here to devise a strategy, a plan. You're really, this is where your logical thinking comes in conjunction with your intuition, okay, and your age-old wisdom that you have. When we do have the either the King or the Queen of Swords, this gives you the energy that you need to cut off situations that are no longer working for you, okay? But it also really does allow you to kind of expand your mind a little bit as well. And, you know, of course, the King of Swords is very much the thinking energy, but also one that does take action as well. Your words really do hold great weight in everything that you do. So this gives you the ability to articulate yourself very well, to have conversations that you need to have. If you're going for a job interview or anything like that, man, oh man, are you ever going to come out on top? Okay, you just really come across as, you know, very positive, very intelligent, all right, but also very intuitive at the same time. It's like you've really got a really good, wonderful balance of energies there. But the King of Swords also gives you the energy of discernment and to figure out where to put your time, energy, and attention, the ability to make really good choices in your life, okay? And, you know, to recognize the fact that if you are pigeonholing yourself in one particular area, the King of Swords really does give you that expansion mindset so that you can look at things from all different angles, okay? All different perspectives. All right, wonderful energy. The Sun is here as well, really shining a light on you, giving you a lot of energy, this big energy boost, this expansion period that we've already been talking about. The Sun really does reiterate that. Thank you. What is reify? Anyway, it really does reiterate that. Okay. But the Sun is about success, about positive energy, happiness, fertility, family, you know, spending time with the people that you love, expanding your horizons in all aspects of your life. No matter what you do right now, you will be successful. So keep that positive mindset, that sunny energy, and it really does kind of shine a light on your entire week. All right. Love the Sun. Okay. So, you know, and it also does infuse you with a lot of optimism, a positive outlook on things, and a really positive perspective at the same time. When we have the World and the Five of Wands, now the Five of Wands is quite often my internet dating or internet job search card, all right, more because the fact that it is about competition, and it can also be about a whole bunch of people trying to achieve the same goal. And, you know, it's it can be healthy competition, it can be a little bit of healthy conflict, but you may be in a situation where you are in competition with other people, and there is a lot of energy that is involved with that. And this can actually be your workplace as well, okay? Maybe, you know, there could be just a lot of people that, you know, while people do have to work together and they do have goals that they need to achieve, there may also be some infighting there as well. A little bit of drama may get in the way, okay? So whatever it is, your situation, there's something about to shift for you when we have the World, all right? The World is an energy of completion, okay? Well, you've gone as far as you can go in a current situation, a current cycle, and you have learned all the lessons that you need to learn, and you've been very successful at them. So you are ready to start something new. If you see this fox here, he's like jumping over all those competitions, okay? Anyone that is causing any drama or anything, and this is really rising above. It's like, you know what? I'm not going to get caught in the battle. I'm just going to jump over it. I'm going to leapfrog over it, and I'm going to go and attach myself to the World energy because I'm ready to start a new phase and I'm ready to make improvements in my life here. And that's what that World energy is. It's one of expansion. It's one of completion. foundation and you are ready to walk forward. You're ready for a little bit of shift in your energy here. So, you know, I feel here if you are, you know, trying to find a job or if you're looking for new love, anything like that, okay, I feel as though you're right on the cusp, you're right on the precipice here. And again, with the diversity energy, you may need to expand your horizons or, you know, put down your walls just a little bit, okay, because you do have the ability to rise above others and really do have the ability to be seen. But again, you may be pigeonholing yourself a little bit and you might need to just expand yourself a little bit, right? That world is, you know, can be about expansion as can be the sun, okay? So, but you do, you know, the stars are really shining upon you right now and you really do have the ability to succeed in everything, but try and find a way to stand out. Okay, so and that could be where a community comes in, especially if you are, looking for a new job or new love, right? You may have friends or family, or there may be something online that can help you stand out in a crowd, okay? Revamp your resume, revamp your dating profile, whatever, all right? But I also feel if you're in a workplace situation or some family situation even right now, there may be a little bit of drama that's been going on, okay? It could be new drama, it could be something that's been going on for a while, and you're either going to step away from that energy. You're like, I ain't getting dragged into this today, okay? That King of Swords, discernment, okay? You're not going to let anyone drag you into anything that's going to weigh you down, okay? And you might just be ready to move on from something, okay? To start, it's like, no, I'm done. I'm just not going to get involved. Okay. So this world energy can have you extracting yourself out of the mix, out of the fray. Okay. And, just focusing on something a little bit different, right? Especially if this is a family situation here and it might not really involve you, but they're trying to really rope you in. You just may be like, not today, folks, not today. And you know what? I got somewhere to be. So, you may be extracting yourself there. All right. But no matter what is going on, there is an energy of success here for you. Okay. So, really things are about to shift. They're about to improve and your world is about to expand a little bit. Advice from Spirit, the King of Pentacles. For one, stay grounded. Okay. The king is very earthy energy, right? So really want to be grounded. And if you look at this king, he's actually a tree with roots in the ground. Okay. So, so don't forget how successful and knowledgeable you are. Stay rooted, stay grounded in your energy. Okay. Don't let anything get you off course, off track, and be committed to whatever it is that you put your mind to. And when you, this is an energy of commitment. And when you are committed to, your goals and your dreams, then you have the ability to really succeed. Okay, so just know what you want. Plant your roots. Where are you looking to plant your roots? Are you looking to keep rooted in a situation that you're in right now? Or is it time to dig yourself up? And is it time to start something new where you can also plant yourself, right? Because the king is very, very committed, but also action oriented. So it feels here, you know, for one, Spirit really wants to remind you about how knowledgeable, how experienced, how focused you can really be, and how needed that you may be in a situation as well. Okay, never discount your experiences when we have the King of Pentacles. Okay, whether you are currently in a situation that you want to be, whether you have achieved your goals or not, this is really saying that if you are committed to something and if you give it your all and your dedication and put all of your skills to work, then you will be successful in all of your endeavors, no matter what that is, love, career, finances, okay, just yourself, right? Everything, you can succeed. But sometimes we do need to make a long-term commitment, and whether it's to a person, place, or thing, or whether it's to ourselves, and that's when we get success, and success will follow. So know what we want so that we can plant those roots. All right. And if those roots have outgrown their welcome, okay, sometimes we do outgrow things, then it may be time to pick yourself up, move on. All right. And be committed to yourself. your outcome energy here. We've got the Four of Cups and the Page of Cups. Just when you think that there's nothing better on the horizon, there's no improvements, there's no opportunities, bam, in comes something. The Four of Cups is an energy of apathy, of a little bit of detachment, of boredom, of kind of almost a giving up energy. And when we do have that, it's always a reminder that just when we're about to give up, something new is coming in. But we do need to shift our perspective, shift our horizons, okay? We may need to diversify our energy a little bit, right? Because something is brewing on the horizon here, an improvement in something, okay, is here, an answer, a solution, you know, a opportunity to heal from something, okay, a new opportunity coming in, or that expansion of an existing one, all right? But we do need to reshift our focus, okay, to look beyond our current periscope, okay, to look beyond our current box that we may be in, and shift our energy, shift our focus, and that's when we find exactly what we're looking for. We find new opportunities, we find new things. The Page of Cups can be an energy of sometimes a little bit of a surprise, okay, a heartfelt surprise. It's a beautiful energy. It can be an apology. It can be a new love. This can be someone coming in. And if you felt as though you're rooted in a situation, let's say for a career or a relationship, and you may have been feeling as though there's kind of, you know, no more opportunities, you know, your boss, your current, your significant other may come in with something that just really uplifts your energy. Okay, it may come as a little bit of a surprise. That Page of Cups quite often comes with a little bit of a surprise. All right, but it's a always very something heartfelt, okay, something honest, something pure, something that you may have had your heart set on and you may have thought that you'd lost it, okay, and it may come around for a second chance again, okay, or if you've been putting yourself out there, let's say for a job, okay, that Five of Wands energy, right, a new job, a new relationship, and just when you think you're not finding anything, whoa, something comes in and really does give you a little bit of a shock, a little bit of a surprise there, okay, but a happy surprise and something that really just uplifts your energy. But that Page of Cups, again, can also be, you know, an invitation. It can be, a new friend that's coming in, okay? It can also be an apology from someone as well, okay? So all these wonderful things that really do connect with you on an emotional level. So really very positive things that are coming in for you. All right, so, but again, we do have that repeating message about expansion and about shifting your focus, okay? Expanding your mind, looking at all of your options and not just one. And of course, trying new things to maybe get you out of a rut, okay? Or get you feeling revived and refreshed again. So let's leave that there, all right, but new offer, new opportunity there, but let's close out your reading with a couple last messages from the angels here. Last messages, please, for Libra. What else do we need to know? Thank you. All right, and we have It's Up to You. Yes, indeed it is, okay? You have what it takes to move yourself forward, to try new things, to be successful in all of your endeavors, whatever it is that you put your time, energy, dedication to. King of Pentacles, success will follow. And, you know, so, you know, with this Four of Cups energy, or if you're in this Five of Wands and there's a lot of activity around you, all right, don't forget you have the ability to leap over anything that is, you know, trying to like keep you held down or you know, getting you confused or in the mix, okay? And you have the opportunity to expand your horizons as well. It's all up to you, all right? And then we also have big happy changes. Look at that, okay? That's that world energy, the sun energy, the Page of Cups energy, big happy changes. What are you looking to try new? What are you looking to change? What are you looking to improve? Because again, it's up to you to take action, okay? Or to put yourself out there, all right? Try new things and big happy changes. This is really wonderful, positive energy here for you guys, okay? So whether that's, happy changes here in this Four of Cups, this Page of Cups within a relationship, a job situation, okay, a family situation even, okay, or, you know, this could even be like some new community, new friends that come in, whatever it is happy, happy, happy sun energy, okay, so love this for you guys. So I'm going to leave this here for you, Libra, but I really hope that there was something in here that resonated. It may have been a small bit, it may have been the whole thing, but if there was, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. I thank you guys so very much for watching. I hope you have a beautiful day, and I hope you have a fabulous week. All right, so I will see you guys next time. Bye-bye.